Hi everyone, it's Katrina. From deep sea horrors from a sci-fi movie to spooky furry critters hidden in trees, here are 10 of the creepiest creatures in the world. Number 10, Cthulhu Larva. Cthulhu larva, which are actually called Scotoplanes, deep sea holothurian, or sea pigs, are a species of sea cucumber that live on the seafloors of the Atlantic, Pacific, and Indian Oceans. They live at extreme depths of between 4,000 and 16,000 feet, where they sift through the mud in search of nutrients. While individuals may seem creepy enough, and rightly said to resemble the offspring of a sea monster or some sort of Lovecraftian horror, the real fright with them comes from the large communities they create. There is rarely just one alone, and in regions where they live, the entire sea floor can be covered in hundreds or even thousands of them. They aren't dangerous to humans and live far beyond the depths we can reach without submarines, but they are the perfect example of the horrors of the deep and make you wonder what else might be down there that we haven't discovered yet. Number 9. Atlantic wolffish. Atlantic wolffish can be found across the North Atlantic Ocean where they live on the rocky seafloor, rarely moving until they detect their prey and pounce. They prefer colder waters, so are only usually seen at depths of up to 1,600 feet, and have developed some unique adaptations to survive in this environment. To ensure their blood can keep flowing in the sub-zero temperatures, they have a natural antifreeze that prevents it from solidifying. To blend in with the background, they can be a range of colors, usually a purple-brown, olive-green, or blue-gray, and their dorsal fin extends all the way down their back. The most striking thing about them, though, is their teeth. They have between 4 and 6 fangs on their lower and upper jaws, and behind these are rows of crushing teeth to help digest mollusks and crustaceans, which make up their main food source. Perhaps these teeth are what gave this fish the name of Scarborough Wolf, or Wolf for short. Growing up to 5 feet long with a weight of 40 pounds, these horrors from the deep may get even bigger. They aren't very good swimmers and slither from side to side to propel themselves through the water. Despite their appearance, their presence is seen as a sign of a healthy marine ecosystem, and population collapses in recent years have caused significant concern, leading to them now being classified as a species at risk. Number 8. Tube-nosed fruit bat. You tell me, adorable or creepy? Tube-nosed fruit bats are endemic to Australia, Papua New Guinea, Indonesia, and the Philippines. In 2010, researchers announced the discovery of 200 new species in the forests of Papua New Guinea. This one was one of their favorites because he looks like Yoda, he does. Locals compare it more to the devil, and like other bats and creatures in Papua New Guinea, they think seeing one is a bad omen. While they have been observed, they are very rarely seen, and researchers know very little about them. They're a solitary species which roosts in the mid-level of the forest. It's thought that they play an important role in the distribution of seeds throughout their habitats, and they spend their lives scavenging for fruit near to water sources. As with everything in nature, their peculiar noses have developed for a special reason and acts as a type of sideways snorkel that allows them to keep breathing while their faces are deep within the juicy flesh of a meal. It's not known how many of them are left in the wild, but because of the significant amount of deforestation across their native regions, it's suspected that they should be considered as being at a high risk of extinction within the next few decades. Number 7. Trogloraptor spider. There are a number of creepy species of spiders around the world, but one of the most freakish is the recently discovered Trogloraptor spider. They are native to the caves of southwestern Oregon and were only first described in 2010, being only one of 3 new spider families to have been found in the past 30 years. Growing to up to 3 inches long, they are yellowish-brown in color, have extremely long legs in comparison to their body size, and at the end of each leg, they have a hook-like claw, hence the name of Trogloraptor. These are vital to their ability to hunt for food in the dark cave environment, where they spin thin webs from the ceiling and hang from them, waiting for their preferred prey of insects and moths to fly past. By timing it correctly, they use the claws to snatch their targets from mid-air and quickly inject venom and start to eat. Luckily, they're not seen as being dangerous to humans and have a shy and evasive temperament. Simply shining a light on them will cause them to run away, but it would surely give you a fright if one fell on you during an expedition. And now for one of my favorites, But first, wanted to give a big shout out to Paul Vamos, who says to keep up the great education disguised as entertainment. And Ashley Boudrim, of course you can have a shout out. If you are new here, be sure to subscribe and join us. And let me know which critter you think is the creepiest in the comments below. Number 6. Big Fin Squid. The depths of the ocean are a mysterious place that remains one of the least explored places on Earth. There are creatures that live down there that are unlike anything seen in shallower regions, and some of them are simply terrifying. The big fin squid is just downright spooky, and the lighting of this video doesn't help either. On November 11th, 2007, a Shell Oil Company ROV captured a magna pinna, or a big fin squid, on video at a depth of 2,386 meters. Found lurking near their Perdido drilling platform, this thing caught the cameras by surprise. The Perdido oil platform is the deepest offshore drilling site in the world, and I'm sure they were not expecting to find this creepy alien sci-fi creature watching them. The first record of a big fin squid is from 1907, and many have been seen over the years, but they are damaged and hard to see when they come to the surface. The only time they've ever been seen in the wild is on footage recorded by deep-sea submersibles, usually around oil rigs, like I mentioned, where they've been discovered at depths of between 5 and 15,000 feet. From these images, it's estimated that they tend to grow to 23 feet long when their legs are fully extended, and are thought to float in the water with their appendages dragging along the seabed in order to capture food. The crew of the submersible Nautil captured the first visual record of a big fin squid in 1988, off the coast of northern Brazil at a depth of 15,535 feet. Then, in 1992, the same crew observed the species off the coast of Ghana and Senegal, both at around 10,000 feet below the surface. We don't know very much about them, but their fins are the length of at least 90% of their body, which includes the mantle and their frighteningly long legs, and they'll often hold their arms at a 90-degree angle from their body, although it's not entirely clear why they do this. Number 5. Hairy frogfish. Also known as the striated frogfish, hairy frogfish are one of the creepiest species you'll find in shallow tropical waters around the world. They grow up to 9 inches long, have huge mouths that allow them to swallow prey their own size, and are able to change their color over a period of several weeks to camouflage in with their surroundings. The most noticeable feature, of course, is the hair-like structures across their bodies. These aren't actually hairs, but are instead spinules or thorns that grow in an irregular fashion and help the frogfish to appear to others as if they are a sea sponge or coral. Whenever anything of the right size swims along, they'll quickly snap from their hidden position and take it in one gulp. They're not particularly fussy about what they eat, as long as it'll fit in their mouth, and they've often been seen devouring others of their own species. Number 4. Lobster moth caterpillar. The adult forms of lobster moths aren't particularly unusual or interesting in any way, but when it comes to their caterpillars, it's a whole different story. Native to Eurasia and northern Africa, they emerge from their eggs with twitchy long legs and begin life by mimicking ants or spiders. Once they've eaten enough food, however, they shed their skin and develop a large head, humps along their bodies, an enlarged rear end, and long, thin claspers. They are usually reddish-brown in color by this stage, and it's easy to see why people think they look so much like a lobster. When they reach full size, they can be up to 2.5 inches long, and if they feel under threat, they can raise themselves up on their front legs to adopt a threatening stance. Seeing one of these walking along a branch of a tree is a particularly unnerving experience because it's so unlike any other moth species, and makes it all the more of a shame that after emerging from their cocoon, they become full gray moths. Number 3. Frilled shark. You probably don't want to be stuck in the water with a hungry shark of any kind, but there is one that's creepy for a completely different reason. The frilled shark looks a bit like a sea serpent, doesn't it? Growing up to 7 feet long, these strange creatures live in the depths of the oceans around the world, but because of their eel-like shape, they swim in a distinctly snake-like fashion. They have been around for a very long time and are often called a living fossil. Their diet consists of squid, fish, and other sharks, and have long rows of teeth that each have 3 points and are ideal for grabbing onto a meal and not letting go. Its mouth is just as scary as the great white. They have 25 rows of teeth, 300 in all. Biologist David A. Ebert, director of the Pacific Shark Research Center, was examining a specimen and says that, "I can tell you from snagging my fingers on the teeth that you can only back out one way, and that's in toward the mouth and then out," he told Wired. "It didn't feel good, I can tell you that." Their long jaws allow them to open their mouth extra wide to take in prey half as long as their body. It will rear its head back and attack like a snake. Due to the deep environments they hunt in, they are very rarely encountered by humans, except for the rare occasions when they get caught in deep sea fishing nets. We therefore know very little about their behaviors and interactions with others, but from evidence collected from their stomachs, they are almost certainly the alpha predators of their ecosystem. The rare times they have been captured on video show a very impressive and spooky creature. Definitely not something we are used to. Number 2. Spider-tailed horned viper. If you're not too fond of snakes and hate the thought of spiders, then the spider-tailed horned viper is going to be the absolute last creature you ever want to come face to face with. They are found in the desert of eastern Iran and have developed an ingenious way to attract birds within striking distance. In a similar way to how rattlesnakes have rattles on the end of their tails, this species of viper has a knob-like structure with drooping scales that imitate the appearance of a spider. Known as a caudal lure, it's an aggressive form of animal mimicry where a tail evolves to look like something else. They're even able to move them to simulate a spider walking along a rock while keeping the rest of their bodies perfectly still. Birds looking down from above will only see what they think is a tasty treat. Once the bird swoops down to eat it though, it's in for a surprise as the snake will whip around and grab it in its jaws. The snake's attack on prey takes less than 1 second. Number 1. The eye-eye. The eye-eye is a species of lemur that's native to Madagascar and is one of the most unusual looking creatures in the world. They are the largest nocturnal primate on Earth and have a specially adapted middle finger that grows to be much longer than the rest. This proves useful when searching for food because their main prey are the grubs that live inside trees. They tap on the trunks with the long finger to locate where a grub is, gnaw with their slanted teeth to create a hole, and then use the long finger to pull it out to eat. Yum! Their long digit is also useful for scooping out fruit. Eye-eyes typically grow to around 3 feet long, most of which is made up of their tails, which help them to move and balance as they're climbing trees. Their teeth are used so often that they actually continuously grow and rely on being worn down while they're hunting. Because of their frightening appearance, eye-eyes are widely feared by local communities. They are seen as the harbingers of doom, and if one is found in a village or it points its finger at someone, it's seen as a sign that a person is about to die. The only way to prevent this from happening is to kill the eye-eye, so as a result, their population numbers are considered to be at risk. Many are killed on site, although today, they are protected by law. Thanks for watching! Be sure to subscribe if you're new here and let me know which creature you like the most in the comments below. See you next time. Bye!